Hi, welcome to another edition of the Spiritual Medicine Digest. My name is Dr. Karen Kan, and I have one major word for you for this past week, and that word is implants. Yes, we are going to talk about alien and entity implants. Why? Because at this ascension level, that is what we are able to heal. And the other thing we're healing is a lot of projected negative thought forms. So negative thought forms, negative thought beliefs. So what's the difference between a negative belief and a negative thought form? Well, actually, it's the same thing a lot of times, except that the negative thought form that's projected is a negative, can be a negative belief that is projected onto a person, but actually does not come from their current life, situation, does not come from their past life situation, does not come genetically from either parent. Yes, you can actually genetically inherit beliefs, and doesn't come from any soul level of beliefs. It's actually projected from outside, and that is, we found that it can be projected from entities, negative entities, or extraterrestrials, and sometimes it's an experiment, and other times it actually is malevolent, and usually that's because entities are also involved with extraterrestrial intervention. So this week, people have been suffering all sorts of different kinds of weird symptoms and pains, especially traveling pains. There's different kinds of implants. One of the types is sometimes called metallics, so made of, metal objects. Others, they're not detectable with any sort of instrument that we have. And so this week, the body has started to create some sort of immune response. Some of the autoimmunity scores have gone up, and it's like the body's like fighting this thing, like, hey, I want to get this thing out. And what we have found is, remember last week, we were talking about how many consciousnesses are controlling you. Well, I thought we were done, for me, going from 8 to 1. But you know what? A few days later, I got 3 again. I'm like, seriously? And what I did notice, that when my husband and I, when we just had one consciousness controlling each of us, we were so peaceful and happy. We just enjoyed each other's company. We didn't argue on the ice. Sometimes we, argue about pair skating, who did what and so on and so forth on the ice, but we didn't argue. And when we did start to bicker a little bit, and then I checked later that evening, sure enough, there was more than one consciousness on board again. And what I discovered this week, this past week, was that we have many of us have implants, not just in this lifetime, but other lifetimes too, which we can now heal, which is really cool. But even in this lifetime, there can be 5, 10, 15, 20, sometimes 80 different implants, some of them metallic, some of them not. So this is a good question to ask yourself, because the body, I think, is ready to release these. And that's why it's coming up now. Remember, I talked about each ascension level, we have this brand new room we've discovered in our castle. And it's so beautiful in there, except it's covered in a layer of dirt and dust and all that kind of crap. So we have to clean out the crap. And so the crap comes to the surface. It's obvious what needs to heal. We could not actually detect a lot of these implants prior to this ascension level. It probably wasn't possible, but now we can, and our bodies are screaming at us like, hey, there's something here I don't like, and let's get it out. So it's pretty simple. You have a couple different options here. So most of you can just go ahead and you can muscle test how many implants or devices, or hidden implants or devices, non-beneficial, that I have right now in this lifetime. You can also ask, how many do I have in all my lifetimes, in all dimensions, in all universes combined, and get a number, whatever that number is. And then you can go ahead and just release them. Now, sometimes they don't all release, and that's where you need some help, either with somebody who does the body code, motion code, or someone that does Topocan healing, because then you can start asking other questions. And if you muscle test, you can actually learn this pretty quickly. You can ask, what what is causing me to be susceptible to these implants? And it can be anything from a trapped emotion to these negative thought forms. So negative thought forms, a lot of them are negative beliefs, and some are not yours. They may not be genetic, or you know, what you grew up with, or from your past life, or even from your soul level. It can be something that's projected onto you from an entity or extraterrestrial source. So you can ask for that. Do I have any projected negative thought forms, and you know, what makes me susceptible to them? And so you can keep going down layer by layer by layer, and it could be a negative vow, it could be a curse, it could be anything, and then you go ahead and dissolve those, and then you do your topo healing command. You intend to use the topocan healing energies from the archangels, and you just say, it is now commanded that these negative thought forms be dissolved and uncreated. The holes fill the highest vibrations of love and light, and thank you. And then just check back in, how many do I have left, and I like to count down so I don't miss any. So you might have started with 341 negative thought forms in all your lives, and now you're down to 5, you know, and then you can ask, well, why are these not being removed? You can also download positive frequencies to help automatically clean. I call those auto clean frequencies, to go ahead and automatically clean, you know, these negative thought forms. And then once you release all those, and sometimes you may have to find the reason for those and clear those reasons, then you can go ahead and clear the implants. Now, sometimes when you have, you know, 40 implants or something like that, and you go ahead and command them cleared, you may have a few stragglers. And the few stragglers, it's kind of interesting to find where they are in the body. And what I have personally found, and you can tell me what you find, but what I have personally found is a very common area is the neck, is probably the number one area. This number two area is kind of split between the head and the belly. I would say maybe the belly I've seen more often. What's really, really fascinating is some of these places where we've muscle tested these implants happen to correspond to places where my patients have pain. And in one case, you know, one of my patients, we tested that he had some sort of metallic implant, or a couple actually, I believe, in the right shoulder. And he happened to go through the big x-ray machine at the airport and was stopped. And they had to search him, and they asked him if he had any metal in his right shoulder. And he was like, no. He had no idea what they were talking about. But it was soon after that we actually discovered it. And in fact, when we were doing the healing work, this pain kept flipping from one shoulder to the other as if it was trying to escape detection. We had eventually found the implants on both shoulders and, did some releasing. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean you're going to get rid of all the implants in, all at once. It may occur in layers. So you can keep checking, you know, do I have any hidden implants or hidden negative, devices, that are affecting me? And then you can go ahead and command them gone. Now, you know, if you are one of my students in the holistic healing event, or one of my patients, you probably have my Ascension CDs, which can be assisting you in this. So basically, if you have those CDs, the clearing and protection CD, for example, you would go ahead and play the CD and just direct the energy to whatever it is you're trying to heal. So just say, you know, I want this energy to go to clearing, you know, all the implants in me and so on and so on, and all my lives, you know, whatever you want to say as your intention. And that will clear layer by layer by layer. And I would say play it several times a day. So there are many different layers of these implants. And what I found was, once you remove the implants, then the ability for other consciousnesses to then tag along and try to control you is gone. So you're no longer susceptible for other consciousnesses to come on board, especially the extraterrestrials. They actually need those implants somehow to be able to take control. So the other interesting thing, we talked about sleep realms the other week as well, and the implants tend to give people a key almost to certain realms that they're not supposed to be in, like the lower realm. There's also another realm that people can go to in their sleep. We found with one person, I call it Dark Angel Realm. So it's sort of like the party room for Dark Angels. And that person was really not supposed to be able to go there. But there were some portals in the astral realm that they were able to slip into that place. And that no wonder they were exhausted in the morning. They're probably feeling like they were in a battle all day long. And there was only one exception to the rule. It was one particular person who her higher self is actually an archangel in charge of healing entities, and she actually was supposed to be in one of those realms in sleep, but was not in Epsilon, which we've discovered that Epsilon brainwave state is where the earth angels rest, and it seems to be about 30 to 35% of the time, sleep time, they should be there resting. And if you're an earth angel and you're not there, it could cause some problems. So we sometimes download positive frequencies to help support you into being able to get into those spa, you know, brainwave state energies. So if you're an earth angel, you'll want to be able to be in that Epsilon brainwave state at least a third of the time in your sleep so you can rejuvenate. Yeah, so definitely go on a squeegee hunt for these implants this week. Tell me what you find out. Tell me where they are. Like I said, you know, you may have to do some detective hunting in some cases if there are some stubborn ones. And the other thing I also noticed is that there's a residual toxicity after you remove the implant. So go ahead and make the intention. You're going to remove, dissolve, and uncreate these implants with love. And also dissolve and uncreate any residual energies or toxicities associated with their removal and any booby traps that might be there. And then fill all the holes with the highest vibrations of love and light. And see how you do and let me know how you're doing with all this. I know it sometimes seems really complicated, but you know what? It's implant week. This is what we can heal. And with every ascension stage, what happens is that the dark energies that can be healed in that stage now come up, are sort of like scum coming to the surface, so you can release it. So don't get discouraged if you're like, wow, I was feeling great, and then now I'm not anymore, you know? So it just means that, hey, you can release the next layer. You can heal at a deeper place. So on another note, you know, the other thing to keep in mind is that when you are testing yourself for how well you're integrating the ascension, I like to ask, you know, get a number out of 100. So how well am I integrating the ascension energies, and get a number out of 100. Every time we go through an upgrade, you may want to check again. So, you know, check once a week, something like that. But then you can then ask for each type of like physically, how well am I integrating ascension physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, energetically. That's kind of the five broad categories. And then now you can ask dimensionally too. How well am I integrating the ascension dimensionally? And what I mean by that is your physical body resonating at multiple dimensions, or is it able to synchronize the dimensions into one for your physical body? So all parts of your physical body are resonating in the same dimension. You can check each of the bodies, the same kind of bodies, physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, energetic, and ask, how many dimensions is that body resonating in? And if it's resonating in multiple dimensions, it could be correlated with some symptoms. Now, it doesn't mean that your mental body has to resonate the same frequency as your physical body, but within the same body, it seems to work better when you can resonate at the same frequency or the same dimension. And so you can go ahead and check that. And you can do a quick healing and just ask. And, you know, it's now commanded that whatever it is preventing me from integrating my ascension energies with ease and grace be now healed in the highest and best way in all directions of time. And I've also downloaded some positive frequencies. You can try this, see if this works for you, but you can command, is now commanded that any beneficial frequencies from all ascension levels that are available be downloaded to me to help me integrate the ascension now and in the future, physically, spiritually, mentally, emotionally, physically, and dimensionally. And just a little quick update on my whole biting insects story. I've been trying to you know, download positive frequencies to repel, you know, biting insects and, you know, take away their ability to be allergenic. And, you know, when I'm outside and I hear them, you know, they start buzzing around me and landing on me, then I start downloading these frequencies again. And I cannot believe there are so many frequencies. And what the heck is going on? And one of my patients says, well, you know, they have a really short life cycle. And I thought, yeah, they do. So, oh, that probably means they evolve quickly, probably quicker than we do. So the other day I was outside and I was being told pretty much I have to do the command and check in every 2 to 3 seconds. That is how fast they're able to adapt to what I was doing. That being said, I have not been bitten by a black fly this season, and mosquito bites have been next to nil, which is amazing for this area, at least for where I live. But I did get attacked by a bunch of no-see-ums the other night, and I woke up and was itching and itching and itching. I had like probably 10 bites on each hamstring, and I'm like, why is it just the hamstrings? Like, what's that about? So normally I can go ahead and, with the body code, clear the heat, clear the toxins, clear the, you know, get the histamine levels down, all that kind of stuff, and usually I'll fall asleep within 10 minutes. Well, 20 minutes later, I'm still up itching like crazy, and I put like the creams on and everything. It wasn't working. I said, okay, I guess I'm supposed to do something else. Usually when the usual things don't work, that means I have to learn something. So I'm just trying to figure out like what it is. And I couldn't find what the heck it was. Well, guess what? It wasn't with me. It was with the no-see-ums. So not until I asked, is there anything non-beneficial attached to the no-see-ums, did I get an answer? Yes. And you're definitely going to think I'm crazy. But you know what? Like Cindy Dale, Energetic Boundaries author, says, would I make the stuff up on purpose? No, I would not. So I'm just the messenger. I'm just telling you what I find. So I find that there are extraterrestrial consciousnesses attached to the no-see-ums. I'm like, really? Seriously? I don't get it. Like, why? Anyway, so I heal them. Yes, all the no-see-ums. I do a healing on all of them, clear them of the extra consciousnesses, and finally, I stopped itching and I could go to sleep. Man, and then I thought, well, you know, I should probably check some of the other insects. Yeah, sure enough, some of the insects had other things attached to them, cords, curses, things like that. I mean, I guess they get it just as much as we do. So I guess we're not so special after all. Or maybe we are, and this is another way to get at us or manipulate us. But anyway, there's all sorts of interesting, fascinating things at each ascension level that we are learning. And so now I know that if I have a symptom that I can't normally clear, that it might not be my symptom. So as an empath, I do have to kind of check that on a regular basis. And more recently, I found that some of the weight gain issues that I'm having, because I'm working on my own boundaries over and over again on a daily basis, and I'm thinking, okay, I'm getting more rest, I'm sleeping well, you know, I have good energy for the most part. I'm like, what the heck is going on? And when I kind of forgot that, gosh, sometimes my body and Mother Earth's body, we share kind of similar energies. And so from time to time, I'm her and she's me. And so when I tested her boundaries, Mother Earth's boundaries, to various different things, including entities and extraterrestrials, they were low. They were in the 60s. So I thought, oh, okay. So some of the weight gain has to do with me mirroring some of her boundary issues. So I've begun some work on her issues. And you know, I asked my body, and those of you that are empathic, you may want to do this, ask your body several times a day, is there any part of me that is feeling
somebody else's stuff or someone else's stuff? Or is there a part of me that's empathizing with someone, something, or somewhere else? If you get a yes, you may or may not need to know who or what it is. You might say, okay, is now commanded that those boundaries with this person, this thing, this place be healed and restored to 100% optimal in the highest and best way. Retest the boundary, see if it is better, and then you can retest, am I still empathizing with so-and-so or such-and-such or so-and-so a place? And if you get a no, then you've been released of that particular issue. So you're healing
your boundaries little bit, layer by layer, with each of these different things that you're resonating with. So if you're an empath, you don't have to suffer the symptoms of being too empathic. So that's the strategy for now. If I find a better strategy, I will definitely share it with you, but definitely check your implants always every day. Check your shield, make sure your shield is up, and check how many dimensions each of your bodies are resonating at, and you may want to do some healing about that, especially if you have some chronic issues. Is very, very common. People with extremely difficult and frustrating chronic illnesses, oftentimes their body is in multiple dimensions at the same time. It seems like the sicker they are and the more frustrated they are, the more dimensions they happen to be in. And usually the higher their spiritual energy is. And oftentimes these are people with higher selves that are, you know, very, very high frequency light beings that have come and incarnated in this lifetime as a human being to help us out. They just don't remember that when they first come in. So that's my job, is to tell them who they really are. And so they can at least have, you know, a sense of solace that, okay, you know, my job is hard and it's supposed to be hard, and somehow be okay with that and learn to heal. So a couple of exciting things coming up. So, On July 4th, if you're around Monday's show, Dr. Dennis and I are going to be talking about life wave protocols for the thyroid. Yes. So you definitely want to check in on that show, either on the replay or live. You can ask us questions live on the show about anything life wave. But he's going to be sharing his protocols for the patches for supporting thyroid health. And we're actually going to be posting on the Patch Training Team blog the really cool image that he has with the different patches. So definitely check in on our blog at Monday's show, so you can bookmark that link with that great protocol he's going to be sharing with us. Also, future shows coming up. I'm really excited. We're going to have Holly Hollowell for the Anahata codes. I talked about those codes before. She's going to be on the show soon. Also, Cindy O'Meara, who is the producer and also stars in the movie What's With Wheat. I just found out about it yesterday, so I've been Facebooking it, and there's a it's pretty cool. I just watched it tonight, and I've been really appreciative of not just talking about like gluten-free and that kind of stuff, but it really explains why today's wheat is so different from days old wheat, and why we're having so many problems with chronic illness and autoimmunity and gut and leaky gut. So really great, pictures of leaky gut. So definitely if you have any sort of chronic issue or autoimmune, you definitely want to watch that movie, What's With Wheat. So I'll be interviewing her in the near future. So stay tuned for that as well. And also coming up in several weeks, we're going to be talking with Diana Kushenbach, who is a police intuitive and psychic and a spiritual teacher, and she's one of my favorites. She's such a nice, wonderful person, and we are going to be speaking about the higher self. So I definitely have some questions about that, because it's been really curious and interesting asking whose people the higher selves is. I thought, you know, wow, I didn't know they even had names. So definitely want to stick in and be in the newsletter subscriber list on KarenCan.com, so you know when these radio shows are going to be aired. And so make sure that you're subscribed to my newsletter, KarenCan.com, and in the very near future, I'm going to be doing a free class on entity clearing. So you should probably get on From Heartache to Joy's newsletter list and make sure you get in the backstage pass, because there is going to be a free class coming up. I'll tell you the date right now. How about that? Thursday, July, I believe it's 14th at 8 p.m. Eastern. So you can only sign up for that class if you're in From Heartache to Joy's backstage pass. So you get some freebies there if you join into that. And so you can get into that class for free. And I'll be having some more detailed information for those folks as well. So have a wonderful rest of the week. I'm sure I'll have plenty of more interesting things to tell you next week. And be safe, and be kind to yourself, and get enough sleep. All right. Take care. Bye. Love you all.